Hallelujah. Yibereka Yahuwah wa Yishbereka. May the Most High bless you and keep you. Zelda More Kuna Ben Yehuda Ben Yisrael. Just taking a stroll, you know, my favorite place, at the Inwood Park. I was just looking at this little ledge right here. See the sidewalk? Okay. And then, see how you can just tip over the side and fall down? Bust your head on the rocks and drown? That's why you always have to be ready for what? For war! Somebody come down this path, want to jack you up, you got to fight to the death. Hallelujah. Preserve your vessel. Understand? Otherwise, what happens? Run up on you, push you over the side. Is that supposed to happen? Ain't going to happen to this old man. Come to push me over the side, guess who's going? Either you or both of us. And 9 times out of 10, it's just going to be you. Okay? Because I'm the only one thinking about it. Hallelujah. Why does my mind run to such dark places? You may wonder. Is he crazy? Is he out of his mind? No, I'm not. I pay attention to what's going on around me. People are dying. And it's always called what? A senseless death. Okay, so I try to make sense before death comes. Make sure that I'm not standing there in la-la land when it comes to me. I'm ready to fight it. All right, you all need to have that mindset because you're playing too many games. Okay, wickedness is running around, taking people out, and you're over there telling yourself it's not going to come near you. That's not for you to say that. Tempt not the Most High, our Elohim. Okay, prepare. First preparation is what? It's mental. It's mental. Okay, to get training to fight and do everything else, first what comes before that? Hey, I'm not in the best defensive posture. I need to make some changes. Okay? And that's what we need to do. We need to start thinking like we're behind enemy lines, because we are. Most of us said he scattered us to the lands of our enemies, not our friends. Okay, is my friend standing here to help me if something happens? No. If I can't guard this vessel, that's it. End of story. Okay, yeah, may the Most High have mercy upon me. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm not going to tempt him like that. I got to be ready. So I keep a mindset to defend this vessel at all times. All right, at all times. And you can see I'm a solitary person. I move in solitary ways. So I get to put my mind on the things that it's supposed to be on. I'm not on my phone texting or yapping into it or running around with my friends laughing about football, basketball, apple pie and Chevrolet and everything else is going on in this place. My conversation is in Yah. Hallelujah. When I have something to say, look what I do. I reach out to you. It's the most important communication that can happen. All right? Not saying that you shouldn't have a life. Okay, I definitely have a life, but I don't let my life distract me, all right? I don't let everything that's going on in Babylon, which means confusion, Babel, confuse me. And a lot of you are in a confused state, whether you want to admit it or not. I see the things that's going on with you. And this is just the stuff you're volunteering. Who knows what madness is going on in your life that you're not speaking about, okay? You need to step back a notch, man. Concentrate on the Most High and concentrate on what's in your zone and what he's given to you. Because wickedness is getting ready to come against all of us. And it's going to try us and test us. It's going to come up against your wives, your little ones. And I'm talking to you men. Because for some reason, I don't know why it is. Israel think that this is supposed to be some kind of co-ed conversation. All right? The Most High is talking to the men. He said his voice is unto the sons of men. Why? Because the woman ain't nothing? No. We're going to talk to the woman. But first we have to have what? The instructions of the Most High. And every time you go to get the instructions, who runs up there and starts talking? The woman. Because that's what they teach here in this place. That's why I'm talking to you. Tell your woman go sit down someplace until you finish talking with the Moray. And then you all can discuss it together. We bringing your woman up there and sitting up to the forefront. What's she going to do next? She going to go fight your battle? She going to go teach the men that you're supposed to teach? What happened when those men rebel against the teacher? Then she's going to come and get you? It's too late. You men ain't stepping up, man. That's what the problem is. You men ain't stepping up. That's why I'm standing here by myself. You know what I'm supposed to be with right now? A cadre of men having this talk with them. We're supposed to be running together, working out together, firing, shooting together, learning these scriptures together, and going to serving the people together. Instead, you're hide on Facebook. But I told all of your women, come on, meet me here in this park. They'll be here. That's to your shame and disgrace. Okay, you concerned with the world. I don't care how much you get on Facebook. You in the world. I see you. Nike down. Okay, it's about your car. It's about your job, your paper. It's about all of that. You know, and I'll sit there and I'll chop it up with you. Why? Because I'm not the one that's going to judge you. But I am the one that's supposed to warn you. You're sitting down and chopping it up too much. You need to report for duty. Okay, that's what the Most High created. He created men to report to men. Y'all, for some reason, you don't get that at all. Man, trust not in man. Okay, why did the Most High put men, number the men from ages 20 and up and put them in the Hebrew army? Who do you think they reported to? Oh, we don't report to man, we report to Yah. You report to officers of 10, officers of 50s, officers of 100, of 1,000. You reported to plenty of men. And see, that's what you're trying to get away from them. Running around chasing tail. Oh, I'm a family man. Yeah, you got the tail at home now. That don't mean your head is in the right place. It doesn't mean that. Until you subject yourself to the teachings, you don't know that you're running your home the right way. All you know is you're running the home in a manner that pleases you. About the Most High. The Most High have subjected us to each other. He subjected us to each other. How we serve him is together. Okay? Not you chilling in your home. And for those of you that are in your home because you realize that we're all half out of our mind, that's a different conversation. But you're not stepping up to have that. Okay? And who am I speaking to, by the way, so we can be crystal clear about that? I'm speaking to you men that's holding down a home with a bunch of sons and daughters up in it and trying to keep that in order. That's big work. I'm watching you men that's running around on your own. Dudes live on their own or got some woman that's not even their wife running around dating. No. That's why the Most High said from 20 years old and upward. Your mind is supposed to be turned toward what? Community service. Okay? And when you build those families the right way, then you can say, yeah, I need to spend more time maintaining that. Okay, you are not in the same boat as those men that have those families. These guys are laboring to keep houses over the heads of their families, to feed their children, to educate them, because Babylon is going after their children all day long. But you, your only battle is getting to the next pair of Nikes before someone else does. You're out of order. Okay, and we're going to start picking you men out. You ain't going to hide amongst us anymore. You ain't paid no dues. Not to family, not to y'all, not to nobody. That's going to change because we're going to expose you. And if you don't want to get with the program, then we're going to make sure that everybody exposes you. And what I mean by expose you? Expose you to you. Not rat you out, not try to extort you. But instead of sitting there talking to you about what you want to talk about, they're going to start asking you, hey, you know, how's your wife and kids? No wife and kids? Oh, so what are you doing with that time to serve y'all? The conversation is going to change. Okay, and you're going to find that the only people that you can continue to move the way you're moving with are those people out in the world. You're not going to be able to do it around Israel because we're getting ready to tighten up the conversation now. And I'm not the only one. The Spirit, when it come down on men to bring these things out, it ain't coming down on one man. Yah is bigger than that. I'm not the only one, and I'm sure I'm not the first one that's beginning to have this conversation with men. Okay, but the jiving time is over now. All right, we're coming into a serious season right now. Very serious. For a number of reasons. The cat y'all been laughing at and cussing out. Who's the cat? Obama. Oh, he ain't this. He ain't that. Where do you see what the hell replaces him? He going to be begging for that Negro. Or whatever he is. Because everybody else is trying to get up in there talking about damn FedEx and you're behind to the jungle. Okay? The hell are you going to do about that? You had it good. You didn't know it. That's why your attitude's so damn lax now. Because you have had it good while that cat was running around. Watch what you get next. Okay, you praying, oh, they'll put the white chick in there, and she's going to give you a break too. You don't know them. She ain't got no break for you. She deal with you long enough to get them votes, and once she get up in there, you're the biggest threat to her. You're what everybody is killing our people over. You think the cops are scared of you? This woman points her finger and people get lynched. You want her to run Babylon? He's a fool. Okay? But one of them is going to be running it. All right? and we need to have our program together. Because we're not protesters. We're not in the Black Lives Matter movement. Okay? We're in the Y'all Lives Matters movement. All right? Y'all getting all caught up in that damn thing. For us, this is another form of Afrocentricity. Black Lives Matter. And how come Black Lives ain't serving Y'all? Okay? Everybody's trying to gather up people in the name of everything but Y'all, and you fall right into it. Now, Black Lives Matter, I see it all over your pages. You think it's the first time something like that came up? What do you think the Black Panthers was all about? All these different groups that have come up, Nation of Islam, all these, it's the same old hustle, man. Black activism. Find me any of that in the scriptures. Okay? You'll see up on my wall, Deuteronomy chapter 30, verses 1 through 7 matters, because that's how we get out of here. And there's a lot of work in those seven verses that we got to get done. And those of y'all that are not about doing that, you're going to start to become irrelevant among the true servants of Yah, because we ain't got time to hang back with that. We got babies that we need to take care of, and Yah is our only way to take care of them. We not like that generation in the wilderness. Okay? We want our babies all pray unless Yah takes care of them, not the other way around. Okay? So we want to do what Yah said. We don't want to continue to anger Yah. We want to appease his anger by our works. Those are our sacrifices now that we send up before Yah to appease his anger, to do what he say, to hearken unto his voice. But I don't know what voice you're hearkening unto. It's not Yah. It's not Yah. You have the stuff you're doing. You show me in the scriptures where Yah told you to go do that. You're hearkening unto your own voice, and you're having a ball in this country, and Yah going to get you. Remember I said that. Okay? If you're going to hide among us, you're going to hide among us so that you can become someone to please Yah, not so that you can drag the curses that's about to come down on you in earnest among us. You're not going to do that. I'm going to throw you overboard like Paul. Hopefully it won't come to that. Hallelujah. May the Most High bless you and keep you, Israel. I mean that sincerely. Shalom, shalom.